definition of linear, from what I've come to know, is that no two notes are overlapping. It's all in a line. It's very linear, trackable. So one, then the other in progression. And all you have to do to really learn this beat first, I would recommend, is just to get on your practice pad and start practicing right, left, foot over and over and over in a seamless line. Not so much like triplets, just right, left, foot over and over. Right, left, foot. Second step would be the right, left, foot over and over. This is one that caught me. It was one of the hardest things. And one of the reasons my teacher had given me the assignment anyway, to challenge my coordination. And because he played it and I was like, oh my God, that's cool. You gotta teach me it. Anyway, thank you, Fred Hayes. So right, left, foot over and over and over. Once you could do right, left, foot over and over, and once you could do right, left, foot over and over seamlessly in a line, then we want to try to put two of each together, meaning I want you to do right, left, foot, and then do two of the other ones, right, left, foot, right, left, foot. Put that together over and over on the pad first. Once you got that, ready to take it to the kit? No.
Don't be a hater.
I'm just saying, this is my opinion. It worked way better this way. I could play it on the drums. I could try to sound like Fred when he did it, but it just did not, I didn't get that progress until I started working it up on the pad. Once you could do that over and over on the pad, I'd suggest to do this beat, we want to try to accent your left hand on the 2 and the 4. If every one of these notes, right, left, foot, is a 16th note, then we'll be going 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. And that would leave our left hand ready or in position to pop or do an accent on the 2 and the 4. So try this on the pad first and say 1E and a accent or 2, or just hit it louder when you say 2. 1E and a 2E and a. 3E and a, 4E and a, like that. Try that on the practice pad before taking to the drum set. 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a, 4E and a, 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a, 4E and a. Once you can do that on the pad, are you ready now to take it on the drum set? On the drum set, this is going to be easy because you worked it up on the pad. Take your right hand over to the hi-hat, left on the snare, and then bass drum. Right, left, foot, right, left, foot, right, left, foot, right, left, foot. It's the pattern, it's on the kit, and as you build that up, you can make it sound cool and cooler and cooler. We'll be right back. that's basically it. One more thing I can share about this beat or linear pattern that blew my mind at one time. A good friend of mine was at a guitar center. His name was Michael Hefner. And he was playing a linear pattern on the cowbell that was just, it was tripping me out. I was like, what is it, man? You gotta show me that, man. Show me that. What is that? I would go back in there and make him play it for me, and I still couldn't figure it out. And he was just like, oh, I'm just doing this. I was like, hey, yeah, thanks for showing it to me. He's like, oh, he's just taking the accent and put it on the uh. And I was just like, oh my God. Check it out. If you take your right hand down from the hi-hat early and pop the but don't pop the other one on the four, you have like this entirely different sounding pattern, which is the cool thing about linear patterns, is because you never know what's going to happen with them. So try this. One E and two E and three E and pop the before four. Yeah, it's the before four.
Oops. One E and two E and three E and one E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a.
And now you can play this. I hope you got something out of this lesson that eventually you could take it, put your own spin on it, and have even more fun on the drums. Thanks so much for watching. Keep time, have fun, and be yourself. Extra, extra, weed all up.